Lesson 2, Introducing Arabic Words. The aim of this lesson is to highlight the way in which Arabic words are constructed. Before beginning the lesson, I expect that students are familiar with the Arabic alphabet, the three short vowels of the Arabic alphabet, and how to pronounce each of the individual letters of the alphabet depending on their particular voweling. It is very important that a student who lacks the ability to read voweled Arabic take a step back and master that particular subsection of the Arabic language before moving on with this book. The central aim of this lesson is to highlight that most Arabic words are made of three base letters, and that placing these base letters on various patterns produces words which reflect the meaning of the base letters in different ways. This will become more evident as you move through the text, but the idea here again is that words are formed from three base letters, and that these base letters can be placed on patterns. Now, throughout the text, we'll use the letters fa, ayn, and lam, which join together to make the meaning of to do or to act as base letters for the various noun and verb patterns. At times, these base letters may provide awkward meanings for various conjugations. However, remember that the goal for the student, at least in the beginning, is to memorize the various noun and verb patterns. Before moving to lesson number 3, the student should be familiar with the Arabic alphabet, its short vowels, and the idea of patterns.